Plattsburgh has three new murals this year, celebrating diversity, history, and eternal sunshine. The organization Outside Art, Plattsburgh Public Art Project, coordinated the large art pieces. Warming up the community with its friendly rays is the Smiling Sun artwork. It's complete but not yet installed, and it's a large sculptural mural that's destined for a downtown wall. Inspiring the community is Reach for the Stars, the Michael Anderson mural that went up this fall. And celebrating the community, the Migrations mural began taking shape on a wall in late summer. Outside Art co-founder Julia Devine says the initiative has coordinated the creation of 12 murals in Plattsburgh now, since she and fellow artist activist Amy Guglielmo started the project in 2016.
We like to say we don't own public art in Plattsburgh. We just hope we've blazed a trail for more public art acceptance, and I think we have, and people are excited, and other projects are happening, and people want to give their walls, and you know, it's been a hard few years in downtown, but I feel like the murals keep happening, and they give people hope, and anyone who comes through can see when they see a mural, oh, this is a place that really cares, or maybe I want to move here. So I think it's a positive thing.
Joining us now is the other co-founder of Outside Art, Amy Guglielmo. Hello, Amy.
Hey, Paul.
Amy, how did the idea for this mural come about?
Well, it always starts with a wall, and then the idea sort of comes and we work around it. This wall behind me used to have many vines on it, and it was filled with birds, and the owners removed the vines and still wanted the birds to come. So we thought this was a great way to involve a lot of community members to participate, and we knew that Gharan was the right artist to bring the vision together.
Yeah, we saw many artists working on the piece, but Gharan Burton was the lead artist this time, and the meaning of the piece goes much deeper than the colorful birds we see. What do these beautiful birds symbolize?
So this is called the Migrations Mural, and the birds represent the people that were born here, come here, passed through, and made our city a better place. And we're celebrating the diversity of the different people, and birds are a great way to represent them.
Yes, we can see the diversity in the many birds and colors. Why is it so vital that we celebrate diversity right now in Plattsburgh?
It's really important to celebrate diversity at this time in our community because there's a lot of division, and we really want to celebrate the differences that make this a special place. There have been so many people that have come through here, and we think sharing them all on one wall really unifies and brings joy and hope.
And we're hearing a lot about racial diversity these days. Was your mural conceived before or after the rise in racial awareness in the wake of George Floyd's death in May?
Actually, we were talking about this mural. We started planning over a year ago in September of last year, and we really wanted to celebrate the immigrants and migrants that come through our community, people that have moved here. Yes, Black Lives Matter, and we want to say Black Lives Matter, but we also really want to celebrate all the cultures. So it's definitely, we're honoring everyone, but it's also something we always keep in mind to be inclusive.
And the creation was inclusive. You've also included about 40 members of the community making this mural, such as international students. Many people have painted birds on this wall, including yourself even.
Well, I was fortunate to participate in this mural. I like to leave my mark in other ways and let other people shine, but I did paint 7 birds on this mural to help out, and I was lucky to help coordinate artists from all over, including Antigua. We have an artist whose parents are from India and Canada. We have a Vietnamese artist who participated, and a Dutch artist, and we have artists who shared French birds and German birds and birds from all over, and a lot of Adirondack birds. So we were lucky to have artists from all over participating.
Yeah, even though we can't travel right now, we can still see birds from all over the globe. What's your favorite bird in the mural, and what other elements do you enjoy about the work?
I was really not concerned, but it was interesting to get 40 artists to work together and so seamlessly, because everyone has varied styles. And I knew Gharan's tree and vines and leaves would unify. So I just love how it all came together. Specifically, I really love, I have to say, my mom's blue heron is really special, because personally we have a blue heron that shows up in front of her house. So it really connects to my family. And I like that each bird is special that way. I also really, really appreciate all of Gharan's birds, especially the ones that are hidden up top, because you have to really look to find them and spend some time with them.
And right now we can spend some time with the lead artist of this mural himself, Gharan Burton. Gharan, where are you from originally?
I'm from Dominica, which is a small island in the Caribbean.
And I notice a bird has flown onto the mural from the Caribbean. What can you tell us about this special bird you painted?
It's found only in Dominica. It's called the Amazona imperialis, or the Cicero parrot, and it's highly endangered. A lot of its habitat got destroyed in the hurricane of 2017, so there are only a few of them remaining in the forest right now.
And the overall piece, what other elements do you like about it?
Overall, I think it's really amazing that that many artists could work on one mural and have it come together so nicely, really.
And I like how you pushed on to create this piece during the time of COVID-19. Amy, why did you want to continue at this time?
I know that COVID was very rough for a lot of people, and it was especially hard as a creative person to find joy and hope when you're not out getting inspiration. But I know so many of the artists that participated said, this is just what I needed, just when I needed it. And it was sort of a rebirth and an awakening. People were finally coming out and spreading their wings.
And apparently there will be more spreading wings. Julia Devine said something rather intriguing about the mural.
It's sort of a mural that keeps on giving because the birds can keep on migrating.
Amy, how can the mural keep on giving?
So when Julia and I discussed making this project for Outside Art, we loved the idea that birds could fly anywhere, and we would love to see them appear on different walls of different buildings and even in unexpected places, in alleyways and on curbings and electrical boxes. It would be really fun to see them in different places.
So that'll be fascinating to see this project continue. And murals continue to go up in Plattsburgh. What's going to be great about the Smiling Sun piece as we move into the colder months?
The Smiling Sun mural by artist Jim Golovich is really going to be something totally unique because he's constructing it out of marine plywood. He's done several layers of paint to make sure it lasts, and it'll be sculptural, and the sun will smile on Plattsburgh year-round, which we really need some sunshine year-round here.
And the other new piece is by Brendan Palmer Angel, the artist who created the Jean Arthur mural in 2019. This year, he's made another significant work.
We're so lucky that Brendan was able to come back and make a Reach for the Stars mural honoring astronaut Michael Anderson, who was born in Plattsburgh and a star from Plattsburgh Air Force Base. And sadly, he passed in the shuttle explosion, but we are honoring his memory, and it's really exciting for everyone to know that there's an astronaut who's from Plattsburgh.
Agreed. That's wonderful to know, and it's wonderful to know people like you who are helping beautify Plattsburgh with meaningful work. Thank you.
Thank you.
If you'd like to see the murals up close, you may reach for the stars with the Michael Anderson mural at 23 Durkee Street in Plattsburgh. The birds in the migrations mural are flocking to 17 Court Street, and you may be finding birds in other downtown areas as well. And finally, when this sculptural mural is installed by the end of 2020 or early 2021, the Smiling Sun aims to shine its rays year-round in downtown Plattsburgh.
Spotlight is supported by the Glenn and Carol Pearsall Adirondack Foundation, dedicated to improving the quality of life for year-round residents of the Adirondack Park.